Hallo und herzlich willkommen. Ich bin's wieder, der Alex, und freue mich jetzt mit Ignazi Trevicek von Portal Games zu sprechen. Und wir werden in ja nur knappen 10 Minuten wirklich über ein paar neue tolle Projekte reden. So, hello Ignazi, welcome. How are you?
Hello, hello, how are you? I'm very well, thank you. Welcome, everybody.
Yeah. So now we have to speed up a little bit. 10 minutes is yeah, that's the challenge here. And so let's get ready. Let us start with Stronghold Undead Second Edition. So original from 2010, I think it was an expansion for Stronghold. Yeah, really famous two-player game. So now it is a standalone game. I'm right?
Now I have it with me here, Stronghold Undead, with a logo of Portal logo, Pegasus logo, expert game. I don't know how much you can see in this Zoom call, but I hope something. Yes, it's a complex two-player game that tells the story of course, sieging the castle. And this one edition is, as you mentioned, old expansion, changed and redeveloped to standalone game. Working on this product was Gianna Kijanka, our developer, who is responsible for example, Empires of the North. This is a girl who is designing games right now with me. So she took this old expansion and redeveloped in the standalone product with many changes to make it smooth, faster, and very, very interesting. For all of you, if you wonder if this is your cup of tea, if this game for you, I would say that it is similar to War of the Rings. This amazing epic game because of the complex and because of how thematic it is. Like this is a complex game. It is like a 2 or 3 hours gameplay only for two players. But if you dig such games, if you like these complex games, oh my God, this is like you are going to defend castle or you are going to attack the castle. Every single action is thematic. Every single action you understand what's happening. Catapults throwing the bullets to the walls, you are defending, you have a priest praying for help against necromancer. So a complex, big game for you if you appreciate the learning game, mastering the game, playing it over and over with your mate. Great design in this very new edition.
So if you are tired to play Star Wars Rebellion, a great two-player game, then you can also switch now to this epic Undead Stronghold Undead Second Edition. So yeah, really, really cool. And as well, a German version is becoming, yeah, through Pegasus Games. So yeah, please wait there. I think maybe in February you can get the game also in German. So a big thing about yeah, Robinson Crusoe is the treasure chest. So everybody wants all these promos, all these stuff in there. And now there is another treasure chest coming. So a full box of great stuff. What is in this new box was maybe not in the older ones.
Yes, so exactly. Let's say the first things first. Thank you, Pegasus Spiele, because Pegasus Spiele inspired me to create this expansion. A few years ago, it was released in Germany only. All our partners or our fans were asking why German gamers have this expansion and nobody else. And we got inspired and we decided this is a great idea. And so this Treasure Chest expansion, this now edition, gathers all mini expansions, all mini promos for different Kickstarters, for different occasions that we ever design and produce. There's also some new content designed especially for this expansion. But basically, this is the type of expansions I absolutely love. You open it, and there's so many different pieces, new characters, new scenarios, new beasts, new events, new adventures. Like you can take cards and add to every single deck, to every single part of the game, new discovery tokens, like everything. So if you are loving Robinson Crusoe, this expansion will not change the gameplay. It is exactly your old beloved Robinson Crusoe, but in each part of the components, discovery tokens, scenarios, characters, you have a new replayability because you have new pieces of content. So this is expansion that is not making revolution, but adding replayability to the next level, whole box of new goodies and as I said,
Yeah.
characters, scenarios, everything.
Lovely stuff. And to be clear, this treasure chest is for the English version only, I think. But there's also something coming for German. And I shortly switch into German. Und für alle, die, die sich jetzt fragen, ah, wie sieht's denn aus überhaupt quasi mit so einer Schatzkiste, Schatztruhe, das ist auch ein ganz wichtiges Wording. Es wird auf jeden Fall auch etwas in Deutsch erscheinen. Pegasus Spiele ist da gerade am Arbeiten, aber sozusagen nicht diese Treasure Chest, die jetzt hier bei Portal rauskommt. Wie gesagt, ursprünglich waren das ja Sachen, die nur in Deutschland erschienen sind. Aber weil natürlich die Fans von Robinson Crusoe da auch immer wieder nachfragen, ist Pegasus Spiele auch gerade im Hintergrund dabei, an etwas zu arbeiten, aber da an anderer Stelle dann etwas mehr Informationen. So, yeah, let us go to the next cool game, Detective Vienna Connection, a new standalone game inspired by the Detective a Modern Crime board game. So, what makes this game new? Is it just the theme or are there some new mechanics in it?
It takes the system from Detective, that is a deduction game in which you read cards and you have to figure out what happened, and add the new mechanism, new rules, so you feel like you're a spy. And in this game, there's so many small tweaks, and I'm so proud from my development team to make it small tweaks that suddenly change the perception, that you feel like you're commanding, because you are in the strategy level, high level, you are commanding the CIA agents in Europe, and you're giving them orders, you're telling them, hey guys, you go there, you need to check it this. Hey, you have local agents in different countries, you can activate local agents. So this is like, no, I am Philip Marlowe from the novels and I'm going to the crime scene. No, now you are managing the whole network of spies in Europe, which is amazing. And you are challenged by the Soviet KGB agents and they have doing some operation and you have to stop it. The game comes with this amazing four missions. In each mission, I don't know if you can see it here, you have dedicated envelopes. In these envelopes, you have a code card because you have to decipher things. You have a local agent, so you can activate them in local cities. You have special covert operations that you can start running in this country, which is insane that you can do covert operations. And of course, there is an introduction that is a goal from CIA in America for you, what you want to achieve in this very mission. The game comes, and this is insane. I don't know if it will be seen here on these web cameras, but I will do my best. The game comes with 100 pages. This is 100 pages of different files, documents, transcriptions, newspapers. Like, this is a full-blown amazing campaign, full of content, full of things that you can discover. Of course, you will never get all of these documents because you have to find them. You will be intercepting transmission from KGB agents talking with you. You have to analyze them, what they are saying there. You will have to decode the messages from KGB agents. So definitely, on one hand, you play this game and say, hey, I play Detective, I feel confident, I feel familiar with the system. And on the other hand, we managed to make this is a spy game. This is a game for the fans of the spy team. And a very important message, we are now promoting English edition of the game, and we are saying it is a spy game. That means that if you like Ken Follett, Tom Clancy, that kind of novel, this is for you, but it might not be for everyone. Remember, this is about politics in the Cold War era, Soviets versus America. This is not a regular crime novel. No, this is a spy novel. This is a different genre. Yeah. We love it. The whole campaign, Four Scenarios campaign, is based on the real event that happened in 70s. And what is more, when we were designing these missions, these operations, they are inspired by things that could possibly happen during the Cold War era when we were doing research about different scenarios that might happen in 70s. So for all of you who like history, this is like history lesson in real like gameplay occasion.
Sounds really great. So sorry that I nearly interrupt you there. So if you are going to this specialization and have fun with this historian stuff, please play this game and have fun with this. So we've got 1 minute only, and let us go to the last point here. Empires of the North, a really great title. Lots of expansions coming out there. And there's also a new expansion in the line, Egyptian Kings, it's called. Maybe two sentences. What is special about these Egyptians?
Yeah, Egyptian Kings is the fourth expansion in the line. It closes the whole first arc of the expansion. So we now released four different factions and we are closing the first arc. And it is once again two decks, ready-to-play pre-constructed decks. You open the expansion, you open the deck, you play immediately. Two very different decks as with every single expansion. And one of them is about the richness of the Nile, so the river, and you have this special rule for the fields, and you have to manage the fields and be fertile and have a new things. And the other one is about being, as with the base game, very rich and goals-oriented and building this amazing location. So once again, two very different types of the gameplay, once again inspired by the Egyptian faction from Imperial Settler, because you are winking to the players, hey, this is like the other one, but with the new version. So I think all the fans will love it. We have amazing reviews for the previous expansions. Once again, the same developer, Gianna Kijankan, designed them. So I would say if you like the previous ones, no brainer, you have to have them all because they are amazing.
That sounds great. Okay, yeah, thanks a lot, Ignazi, for this quick, but really great talk. I wish you the best. Und ja, auch euch da draußen wünsche ich natürlich alles Gute. Ich hoffe, ihr konntet einige Informationen hier mitnehmen. Also wieder tolle Titel, die da von Portal Games kommen. Und schaut natürlich auch mal bei der Keynote von der PortalCon vorbei. Ich bin der Alex und wünsche euch viel Spaß. Ciao.
Thank you. Auf Wiedersehen.
Ciao.